You are a Pandaren, born and raised on the mysterious Wandering Isle. While many of your fellow Pandaren prefer a tranquil life, the lure of adventure burns in your blood. Recently, the Wandering Isle has begun erratically weaving about the world's oceans. The air grows cold, and your island home is spiraling toward disaster. As one of the most promising of students at Master Shang's monastery, you may just be the salvation for your people. But first, you must complete your training.
Hello everyone, my name is Holy Calic, and welcome to my very first episode of my Let's Play series of World of Warcraft. So for the past week, I've been debating whether or not to add World of Warcraft to my channel. But long story short, a WoW streamer off Twitch kind of convinced me that I should do it, and so here I am. Now I did play this game a long time ago, but a lot has changed, so it kind of feels like a new game to me. So first thing I'm gonna do is give myself some extra action bars. It kind of looks like my keybinds are already set up for me here. Since we're gonna be using this a lot, let's go ahead and move it over to E. And this looks like CC, so let's go ahead and move it over to Shift 2 for now. I might change that later. And this is not important. So I think we're good to go. Let's go over to this guy and see what he wants. Today is the day when your fate will be decided. Do you have the strength and cunning to be a monk, or are you destined to a life working in the fields? Each has its place, but I can sense that you aspire to greatness. Let us begin our training, my newest pupil. First, you will need a weapon suited to your talents. Retrieve a staff from one of the weapon racks below, bring it to me, and show me that you know how to equip it properly. That seems pretty simple. Let's go ahead and go over to the closest one. Right click, and that's it. A fine weapon. It should suit your needs well. Now let's put it to use. I'd like to observe you putting your new weapons to use, my young student. This will aid me in determining what degree of training will be best suited to your talents. We have many training targets in the training grounds below. Practice your attacks upon them, and return to me once you're feeling comfortable with your new weapon. So, while I was creating this character, I had a very hard time trying to decide whether or not I wanted to make it male or female. I did know that I wanted to try out a Pandaren, but I did not know which animations I would like better. So I spent like an hour or two looking at the animations over on WoWhead. They came out pretty equal for me, but what really won me over was the sleeping emote for the male Pandaren. I don't know, I just find it a little hilarious. Anyway, one of the dilemmas I was having that was preventing me from putting WoW on my channel was, well, the fact that there is kind of like an unspoken rule that you don't do a let's play of an MMO. There are a lot of repetitive tasks, the quests can seem kind of dull and boring. What I'm trying to say is that a lot of people who play the game already hate questing, so why would anyone want to watch it? The answer is, well, nobody does want to watch it. Hold that thought for a second, let me turn this in first, and I'll continue on that. Not bad, Chaofun. You may indeed have chosen the proper path. Good, let us continue. Facing a living opponent is a very different thing from the stationary targets in the yard. Living opponents strike back. There is the very real fear of failure and sometimes even death. You must have the courage to overcome those fears. Challenge the other trainees within the temple or down the steps below and defeat them. Anyway, like I was saying, I've been watching a lot of Let's Plays on YouTube. A lot of them from my own subscribers. A lot of them are people that I've met and that I've talked to here on YouTube, and I've come to find that, you know, I enjoy watching a lot of them, no matter what game they're playing. It's kind of like watching a friend play a game, almost. Whether you hate it, like it, or don't know about it, someone else is there with you and making that experience more enjoyable, and that's what I feel people enjoy most out of Let's Plays. To see a game from a different perspective and see why other people enjoy the game. There are YouTubers out there with 700 episodes of the same game. There's no doubt in my mind that the game has probably gotten very repetitive by then. And if people were watching Let's Plays for the games, then why aren't channels that do Let's Plays without commentary more popular? So despite what everyone else has said about doing Let's Plays of MMOs, I decided to go ahead and do it. There are definitely a lot of exciting moments in WoW. Hopefully I could show you guys, and also hopefully it doesn't take 700 episodes to do so. I mean, that is really insane. I can't imagine doing 700 episodes of something. So we have three more of these guys to go. This definitely would be a lot faster with heirlooms, but unfortunately I don't have any leather heirlooms on my account. I never thought I would be leveling a leather wearing character after my rogue, so I never bothered getting any of them. I could work on getting some. Oh no, I just remembered, you can't mail to characters in this zone. I'm actually not even sure if you could come back here after you leave. Okay. Intriguing, my young pupil. Most of the other trainees have been here for quite some time, but you are able to match them even within the first hour. This speaks well of you, but there are yet other lessons I would see you learn. Every wisdom has a time and place, and times are changing for those of us living here on Shenzhen Su. For this lesson, I would ask two things of you. For the first, I hold a flame in my hand. Gather your wits, and when you think you are ready, attempt to snatch the flame. Should you succeed, I want you to then climb to the top of this temple and burn the Edict of Temperance that you find there. Okay. Do I just... On your first try, oh wow, I didn't even have to click his hand. It was just floating fires of fiery stuff. So now we have to go to the top of the tower and burn the Edict of Temperance. You know, I actually got lost in one of these temples on my paladin because you couldn't see the stairs from when you first get up on the second floor. Anyway, here's the Edict. Let's go ahead and burn this guy. And then, oh, let me equip these before I forget. You know, actually, I should move these to the bottom of the bag too so I don't forget to vendor them later. Anyway, I'm hoping to record this guy's journey from level 1 to level 90. I don't know how I'm gonna be able to stick with it. I'm kinda already guessing that it's not gonna be popular on my channel. But, we'll see. The fact that you were able to snatch the flame so easily is no small feat. The Edict of Temperance is a scroll of wisdom passed down from my elders' elders, wisdom from a more peaceful time. Every lesson has its time and place, and with darkness on the horizon, the time for this particular wisdom has passed. The burning of the scroll is an acceptance of tidings to come and a promise to action. Your hand carried the flame, and I suspect that it will continue to do so in the future. Chaofun, I see great strength and great courage in you, and an unsurpassed purity of soul. The hour is young, but I think you may be ready to face a greater challenge. Go to the bottom of the stairs and cross the bridge. There you will find Zhao Min Ro, one of our eldest students. Challenge and defeat him in honorable combat, and this first phase of your training will be complete. That's a little far-fetched, don't you think? I mean, it takes years of training to be a monk, and here it only took me less than 10 minutes. I think, what's the timestamp right now? It only took 8 minutes and 30 seconds. Oh well, I'm not complaining. The faster we get out of here, the better. Where's this guy? Oh, looks like someone else is already fighting him. And since he's a quest target, it also looks like I could get credit for the kill. So... yep. Nice. Very nice. You truly impress, Chaofun. It seems certain that the path of the monk is indeed the path for you. In such a short time, you've shown me that you have the potential to be a great monk. The training grounds are behind you, but now you must prove yourself by facing a far greater challenge, one that none of my students have accomplished. I want you to return Hyo, the Spirit of Fire, to the Temple of Five Dawns. My two other most gifted students will help you with this task. The first is Asa Cloudsinger. Seek her out at the pool to the west. Is it Asa or Isa? So, let's go ahead and continue on our journey. You know, I really like the way this starting area looks compared to the other races. Yeah, definitely one of the better ones hands down. I really liked the Blood Elf starting area, but I guess this one's gonna be my new favorite. I don't know, we're just gonna have to see how some of the quests go down later on the road. I mean, they've been pretty ordinary so far, but if it's anything like Wrath and Kata, there's definitely gonna be something epic later on. Oh god, the running. If there's anything I hate about leveling, it's the running. Well, I mean, I hate leveling already, but the running just makes it worse. Fu's Pond. I know somebody named Fu.
Hello.
Why can't I click you?
Greetings.
Oh, okay, there we go. I came to ask the famous Asa Cloud Singer for help, but I just can't bring myself to intrude on her exercises. She's so poised, so practiced, so beautiful. You came for Asa. You really shouldn't interrupt her until she finishes her exercises. She doesn't speak to anyone until her routine is done. In the meantime, could you maybe help me? I had some bad luck with four sprites. Well, I guess so. Amberleaf scamp swarmed my cart and stole most of the training supplies I was bringing up to the training grounds. They've always been troublemakers, but they've never been this aggressive before. I don't know what happened. Please help me recover my supplies. Okay. My driver went running off after the sprites just after they attacked. I don't think they'll really do him any harm, but I need him back to help me clean up the mess by the cart. He chased them off towards the cliffs to the north. If you head that direction, you should find him quickly. So it seems that we can collect some of the supplies directly to the west, but I'm just going to go north so we could find the driver and get the training supplies at the same time, killing two birds with one stone. Oh, this female panda has a foxtail. Now, a lot of people wonder why the female pandas have a foxtail. There's actually an animal called the red panda, and it kind of looks like a fox almost. I think they're considered a lesser panda. But yeah, that's why some of the Pandaren have foxtails. Also take note that they only come in the red variant. I could be wrong, but I don't think red pandas and pandas are related at all. I'm starting to get tired of only having one skill. Hopefully I get a new one soon. Maybe this next level up? Maybe? I think this is the driver, right? So do I have to beat up all those things around him? Oh no, they just go running off. Oh, finally a new skill. Okay, so this is a debuff, so I'm gonna go ahead and put this on number 3. 3 sounds good for now. And I need one more of these guys so I could complete the quest. Okay, let's grab this and head back. That isn't too far. It's kind of far. I think it's okay. You know, during the time that I was playing WoW, I actually had the music off, because I would be playing my own music in the background. But you know, I'm actually starting to like it a little bit. I am really hoping though that this music doesn't content ID match. But you know, surprisingly, I haven't gotten any content ID matches yet. Watch, I just jinxed it.
Compassion and humility. By helping Merchant Lorvo, it would seem you have passed. Master Shang would be pleased.
You needn't worry about hurting the sprites, they're really just living plants when it comes down to it. They'll re-sprout later. I'm sure they will. Thank you, you're an honorable monk. They've taught you well. You are too kind, monk. I know, I try. Let's go ahead and equip that cape, and kind of like reorganize our bags a little bit. You know, actually, maybe I should move them to the newer bag I got. There we go. In time, all answers. It's a pleasure to meet you, Monk. I am Asa of the Tushui. I've spent much time in thought since Master Shang told me we would be searching for Hyo, the Spirit of Fire. I know where he resides, but not how to reach him. The answers are close, however. Come with me to the Cave of Meditation nearby. It is a place of great wisdom. I will meditate there, open my mind, and the path shall find us. Okay. Whoa. I wish I could do that. Look at my small bunny hop. Nothing compared to that. Looks like I have some help. Or not. Looks like I have my own face here. Oh, that's cool. I have a little bar to show me my defense progress. I don't think that was a thing back when I played. Oh, I almost forgot I had the skill. You know, this kind of feels like playing a rogue a little bit, except the combo points are actually carried on you instead of your target. I remember rogues wanting that change a while ago. And by a while ago, I mean like a couple years ago. And then they gave us that redirect skill. It looks like someone's coming to assist me. And her name is... Mane. Could also be Ma-na-i? Ma-na-i? I wonder if that's gonna be a bank alt. Ooh, and that reminds me, I used to raid with someone. And the name of her tune was Oranus. But if you mispronounce it, it actually sounds like our anus. And she got picked on a lot just because of that. So when you create a new tune, always make sure that you say it out loud and kind of mispronounce it. Because you definitely don't want to be stuck with that kind of problem. Oh, I like this guy. I like how he teleports to me after I finish the quest. Your path is set before you. You will be the one to rekindle the Spirit of Fire and bring it to the safety of the temple. This will not be the only time you and Asa work together. She is strong and wise. You can trust in her. Yeah, I agree. Those are pretty good qualities. She's also bouncy and cuddly. Another of my most talented students is awaiting you in the Wusong village to the northwest. He is of a different mind than Asa, but in their differences, they bring balance to each other. Chief Firepaw will instruct you on gathering the offerings for the Spirit of Fire. Trust in his wisdom. Okie doke. So, it looks like we have quite a walk. Season 15 started today. Since I just started playing again, I don't really have anyone to arena with. I did arena with my guildmates for about 2 hours, but we didn't really get far as far as raiding goes. We did win quite a bit, but not as much as I thought we would have. I mean, I think our comp is solid. A lot of people might not. I think it's a very underrated comp, and it should be enough to get to 2k, but I don't know. We will see. So it looks like monkeys are raiding this village. My guess is that we're gonna have to beat a certain number of them. He just said monkey butt. The time to act is always now. Hello, you looked poised and confident. I like that. I've heard some rather impressive whispers about you from the training grounds. If you're half as capable as they say, I think you and I are going to be good friends. We call those vicious monkeys swinging into town Hozen. They keep to themselves normally, but they know something bad is coming, so they're here to steal our supplies. In situations like this, the clear answer is the only answer. These monkeys will leave when we force them to leave. To not defend our town and those we love would be the only true crime. This is the way of the Huojin. Rude. He could have waited for me to accept the quest first. And I think I might be mispronouncing that. It could be Hyojin. Not sure. I'm actually the kind of player who would skip quests and cinematics, so I'm not really sure if they mentioned it somewhere. That's two. Can I reach this guy? Oh wow, yes I can. Where did this other guy come from? I guess that's okay though, because that is one less Hosen I have to run towards. That makes four. Five. Let's see if I could hit this guy in the tree. Up. Up. Six. And then let's attack this guy over here. There we go. Seven. Ooh, and I leveled. Level four. Have a long way to go to level 90. Eight, and we're done. Let's stay away from this guy. Stay away from me. Okay. Oh, he followed me. He's probably angry that I killed his friends. Wasn't my idea, dude, I swear. It was this guy. This guy who's not even helping.
It's good to see you.
You've got some fight in you. I think I like you. Well, I'm sorry I don't swing that way. Now that that's done with, let's get to it then. Hyo, the spirit of fire, hungers for dry dogwood root kindling. It grows among the trees south of the village. It should be easy enough for you to gather some.
The greatest virtue.
Strange thing about the wind, it can be hard to wrap your hands around it. Best practice for me has been finding some sort of living wind. If it can punch you, you can punch it back, and it won't slip through your grasp. Head over to the Shrine of the Summer Breeze to the south and summon just such a living wind using this windstone. Best it, gather a fluttering breeze from it and come back over this way so that we can figure out what's next. So now we shall go south to collect some wood and grab wind. Yes, that sounds about right. There's a lot of foxes here. You'd think there'd be a quest where you have to collect something from them. Yeah. I see the shrine up ahead. I also see some wood. This Hosen's probably gonna attack me, but not too much of a problem. I do remember back when I started playing in BC, the starting questing areas would be kinda dangerous. I mean, you could die if you weren't paying careful attention. Mostly it was because all the mobs were aggressive and they were so close to each other. Not only that, the regen was kinda slow also. So I mean, warriors had to actually eat in between fights. And they actually had a level that way too. But now it's kinda like there's barely any downtime between fights for any class. I mean, I don't miss it, but I don't know, it's just a lot different than back then. So let us loot this breeze thing and collect more wood. Okay, I just need one more. And I see one all the way over there. I like jumping. It makes the running seem so much more entertaining, but not really. Anyway, now we are going back to the village so we can turn in these quests. Hopefully afterward we can finally go up and get Hyo. I don't know how they could drag this questline any longer. I mean, we helped our two buddies out already, so it should be enough. Hopefully. I kind of want to avoid these guys and just get to turning in my quest.
I'm with you.
I hope you are not shy about getting your hands dirty. Chaofun, you've returned, roots in hand. You're a down-to-business kind of guy, aren't you? I like that. When opportunity arises, it is our responsibility to reach out and grab it. Second-guessing is as good as giving up. You know what it is to seize opportunity? I think you and I are kindred spirits, Chaofun. Well, hey, thanks. I've never had anyone say that to me. Okay. Whoa, camera. I really like how Master Shang travels to me. More quest NPCs need to do this.
Our greatest trials yet
lay. You've done very well this far, my student. You have the materials you need to rekindle Hyo, the Spirit of Fire. In the cave to the southwest he awaits, but he is guarded by Master Li Fei, the Pandaren Elder you met in the Cave of Meditation. Go to Master Li Fei with the offerings, prove yourself, then meet with Hyo. So now we shall travel to the southwest. It's kind of far. Just gonna try and get there as fast as I can. There's a lot of hoes in here, but I'm going to see if I can just run past all of them. When I say the word hosen, it kind of reminds me of hoser. I'm not Canadian, so I don't know what it means. I don't know if it's a racist thing either, so I apologize for that. I did learn it from How I Met Your Mother. If you feel offended, please blame them. So we have arrived at the Shrine of Inner Light. So all we need to do now is find Li Fei. This is not him. Can I squeeze through here? Oh, no, I can't. Minus 10 DKP right there. I've actually never been in a raiding guild that uses DKP, though I have been in a guild that uses EPGP. It's kind of the same thing, except a little more fair. Life isn't about finding yourself, life is about creating yourself. There is a path before you, but you choose the trials you will face and the trials you will overcome. You're strong of mind and strong of will, but you lack the skills to face me in combat. You must fight with your body, but in truth, it is your character that is being tested. Let us even the playing field. Take this torch, light it in the brazier next to me, and then use it to light the three unlit braziers around the pool. Okay, so I guess we'll right click this, and here's one, two, three. These fires will give you the strength that you've not yet obtained. They will illuminate your potential. It is time for you to face me. With these three fires illuminating your potential, we will see with certainty whether your resolved soul is truly worthy of passing. Okay, well, let's get to it. Ouch. So, it doesn't appear that his health is going down much, meaning that this could take a while. That skill is pretty cool, the Feet of Fury, and then he does that little teleport thing, right? Where is it? There we go, there it is. I wish I could do that. Why do all the NPCs get the cool skills in this game? You know, this almost looks like a setup for a fighting game, because you have all the sides blocked off, and then there's just two of you, and it takes forever to bring the health down. Definitely not capturing the feeling though, as I only have two skills and, well, there's not really much to do, except press E, and then three. Because of how long this is lasting, I kind of feel like they were trying to capture the epicness of a one-on-one battle. They could have at least put in some fighting music in though. Sorry about that, guys. I apologize if you are now deaf. Anyway, it looks like his health is almost gone. Oh, okay. That works too. Yeah, now that I think about it, that's a little embarrassing. I should probably edit that out. Remember always, the superior warrior is modest in his speech, but exceeds in his actions. Cool. You are worthy of passing, Monk. Hyo, the spirit of fire, rests in the chamber beyond. Let him feast upon the kindling you've gathered, and use the wind to fan his flames. Doing so should endear you to him. Once he is ignited, if he is willing, lead him to the Temple of Five Dawns, the building standing high in the center of the island.
Family, friends.
Okay, so that must be Hyo. Okay, so do I click him? Oh no, there's an item over here. Am I doing it? What's going on? Oh, okay. Okay, seems like it's working. Through the glare, it looks like Hyo is smiling. He seems to have warmed up to you. Okay. Oh, I'm so sorry, guys. I accidentally double-clicked it out of habit. I'll try not to do it again. No guarantees, though. Like I said before, I've never read any of the quests before, so it's kind of like, it's really hard not to spam left click, trust me. If you are like me and have never read these quests before and just kind of like spam left click also, I challenge you to try it. It's not that easy. Anyway, we are now running to the Temple of the Five Dawns. I think following this road is the fastest way. Go straight down. And I really like this sprinting animation. It's like running like a ninja. Is that Hyo? Well, these are some nice stairs that I'll never see again. We have discovered the Dawning Stair. Oops, got stuck a little. And we have reached the Temple of the Five Dawns. Temple of Five Dawns, not of the. Have I been saying of the?
Welcome, Hyo. The people have missed your warmth.
I see Asa and G are here. Chaofun, you've done very well. Hyo, the spirit of fire is here. The Temple of Flames are reignited. You accomplished the challenge I put before you, and with seeming ease. There is a greater purpose in bringing Hyo to the temple. It is time that I tell you more of things to come.
You have conquered every challenge I put before you. You have found Hyo and brought him safely to the temple. There is a much larger problem we face now, my students. Shenzhen Su is in pain. If we do not act, the very land on which we stand could die, and all of us with it. We need to speak to Shenzhen Su and discover how to heal it. And to do that, we need the four elemental spirits returned. Hyo was the first. Jin, I would like you to go to the Dailo farmstead in search of Wu Gao, the spirit of Earth.
On it!
Asa, I want you to go to the singing pools to find Shu, the spirit of water.
Yes, master.
And you shall be the hand that guides us all. Speak with me for a moment before you join Asa at the singing pools to the east.
Okay guys, I think I'm gonna stop this video here. This is my first proper Let's Play on my channel and the longest video on my channel. So, you know, it'd be nice if you left a comment and let me know what you thought. Anyway, I'm sorry that things have been a little slow lately. Reviewing games takes a lot longer than I thought it would. But yeah, as per usual, if you like this video, remember to like and subscribe, and if not, go ahead and leave a dislike. But either way, thanks for watching, thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Later, guys.